One word that is in our forecast, raw. And Jason Michael is here, and he was like, raw. And I'm like, you'll hear people saying it at the grocery store. Man, it's raw out there. It's just cool, showers, damp feeling. Just exactly what you want on a Thursday, right? Well, it is fall now. Temperatures in the 50s all darn day long. We may have some 40s in the morning for just a little bit of variety. There's a look at the radar over the last 4 hours or so. Boy, that line of thunderstorms that fired up, swept east, really caused some problems, mostly with heavy rain. But we did have some locations that reported some damage. You can see that little icon right there in Ashtabula. That's the location where some wind damage was reported. Part of a canopy at a gas station in Ashtabula Township collapsed this evening in those storms. This is the Clark Station at Route 20 and Ridgewood Avenue. The owner tells us that luckily none of the pumps were damaged and they were still able to stay open tonight. Thankfully, nobody injured as well. So what is driving all of this? Well, we have a pretty significant system that's fired up across the lower Great Lakes. It's an upper level system, and boy, once that connects in with some lower level moisture, we can really see some impressive things happening. The swirl is here, definitely noted. An area of low pressure here at the surface developing, and it's just kind of sitting over the lakeshore areas right now. But the biggest problem is that this is driving in colder air, much colder air to the west, and that is just beginning to trickle in. 63 now Ashtabula, 53 in Mansfield. 24 hours ago, we were 14 degrees warmer in Mansfield. It's been a pretty distinct change, and I think it'll be a very notable change from today to tomorrow as well, because the core of the cooler air is sitting out to the west of us. Last night, I showed you the 24-hour temperature change map and said, this is coming. Well, here it is. It's right on our doorstep, and tomorrow morning with temperatures in the 40s to right around 50 to begin the day, and then we don't make it out of the 50s, it's going to be about a 15 to 20 degree temperature drop for most areas. Now, there is the larger part of the storm system out to the west of us, the upper level low. Cold air in the upper parts of the atmosphere just really fires things up. Remember, anytime we have warm air underneath cold air in the atmosphere, that causes instability. So tomorrow morning, we are likely to start with the clouds just because of so much agitation in the atmosphere and humidity. But then you throw in a little bit of daytime heating only into the upper 50s, and that can pop up more showers. So we still have a lot of showers going on to the west of us. We still have the onshore flow. Flood watch continues for Erie and Huron counties. We also have the wind advisory that's going on for Lorain, Erie, and Huron counties tonight. National Designer hour by hour forecast, lots of clouds. There's your showers. Look at these temperatures, everybody. 40s to begin the day to right around 50 degrees. The other part of it is not just the clouds, the showers, and the cool air. Look at the winds. It's going to be whipping tomorrow. It's going to be raw with those winds out of the south at 50 to 20 miles per hour throughout the day. Noontime temps, 50 degrees. It's not going to be terribly warm. I mean, this is what I meant by pumpkin spice Thursday. It's going to feel that way. And that southwest wind out of 20 is just going to be driving that cold air in here all day long. Scattered showers. Look at this. Still 50 degrees or so throughout much of northeast Ohio. We're kind of stuck in this, right? It all starts to change. This time of the year, it's actually pretty nice because these storm systems don't typically last too long. They move rather quickly out of here. And you can see by the time we get into the start of the day on Friday, things look a little different. We get some sunshine in here. Yeah, it's going to be chilly, but we'll be off to a warmer forecast after that. So here's your Union Home Mortgage forecast. Look at this, 58 tomorrow. What a bummer. Then we're up to 71 with clearing skies like nothing happened on Friday. A few showers coming through with another little cold front on Saturday, but that's going to clear out by the time the Browns take the field on Sunday with a mix of clouds and sun in upper 60s. And then we're right there in the 60s and low 70s as we head through the rest of next week into next weekend. So guess what? It's fall, y'all. We'll go there.